Okay. One Piece chapter 865. There we go, man. We got that beautiful screen back into place, man. I'm loving this right here, man. I'm loving this. Like, one of my favorite panels. There's two panels in this chapter where it's just like, holy shit. Like, the first one, and you got this double page spread, and you got Big Mom, and she's just crying, and you see all the faces literally positioned all around her as she's letting that scream out, right? And everyone's got this oh shit look on their face. That is so nice. Like, from the eyes to just the look on Big Mom's face, the eyes of the other people. Like, that was really, really nice. But I would have to say my favorite panel in this chapter, oh shit, dude, I might be a Sanji fanboy right now, because Sanji got the heat going down from his feet. It's melting all the candy. He's got the cigarette coming out, and he's got the smoke billowing, and his family's just looking up at him, and it's just like, yo, that's like the ultimate zero to hero story right there, because Sanji wasn't supposed to be shit, and yet he's the one saving his family. Oh, shit. Like, I wanted to see Sanji versus his father, but I think in this moment right here, Sanji's gonna be given the opportunity to actually show his father what true strength is. So I thought that was really interesting to see. Now, the other thing, though, is I like how, you know, you got Caesar, and Caesar's continuing to look out for himself. He's just like, look, you know, Broly, I need you to just chill the fuck out. They already know that you helped them out. Like, it is what it is now. But my heart is over there. I'm not going to let my heart, I think it's Capone that has his heart. He's like, I'm not going to let my heart basically be stomped out because that idiot's got it. If anything happens to him, it happens to me. So I thought that was interesting how, you know, he puts the mirror down, and being the coward that he is, Caesar's watching everything, and he's just giving the play-by-play. I'll keep it real with you. I didn't think Luffy's plan would work to actually show Big Mom the photo and make her even more pissed off. I thought she was just so pissed off to a point that, you know, she wasn't seeing straight. So I thought that was interesting to see that bit right there. And I like how Katakuri is like, you know, why are you sabotaging us? Why are you working against us, Capone? And Capone, in this moment, Capone is being an absolute badass. So I thought that was interesting. And I like how, you know, they're continuing to talk shit to Judge and them, and they're about to get it several times over. Because even Judge says, like, if only I had my raid suit, you wouldn't even have got the opportunity to try this. And while this is going on, they're telling, like, raid suit, is that some type of a weapon? You know, you want to try and sneak weapons into your own son's wedding? They're just rubbing salt into the wound. And I like it. However, I think that's foreshadowing. Whatever these raid suits are, you know, it's going to be something that's probably going to tip the balance, because, I mean, Sanji's family uses that technology shit. So, I mean, that makes sense that they're kind of going in that part right there. But for me, I'd say, like, my third favorite part of this chapter is going to be how, once again, you see the humanity in Reiju. Because in Reiju, you get this moment where she looks over at Sanji, and Sanji is telling her, like, go ahead, Reiju, run. He doesn't say it to any of his other family, but his sister, the one that freed him. You know, Sanji is like, okay, you rescued me. It's my turn to rescue you. I thought that was a nice bit of character development for Sanji, as well as a parallel to what happened when Sanji was held hostage and how Reiju helped him escape, and now Sanji's attempting to do the same thing. And what I like is how Reiju is showing elements of their mom, because Reiju says, well, Sanji, I suppose I overlooked your kind-hearted nature. Now you won't even run for safety and leave us behind. It'd be the smart thing to do. I lived my life with shame and hatred of the Vinsmoke name, but now that I've seen you all grown up, I feel like my heart has been redeemed at last. There's still a conscience to be found in our bloodline. Thank you, Sanji. And she has the look on her face of somebody who is essentially ready and prepared to die. She's made peace with the demons that she has. And so I was fully expecting to see something like what you got with Belle Marie, where Belle just got, like, the bullet right through her head, right in front of Nami and Nojiko back during Arlong Park. So I thought that was going to be kind of something that would happen here. Sanji would see his sister shot. Now, that didn't actually happen, but what we see is how Katakuri basically looks like Capone was able to stir up some of those bullets that were shot. He fires them back into Katakuri, and it hits Katakuri all over the place. But, you know, being the boss that he is, he's able to kind of shake it off. He uses his devil fruit ability, and Luffy hadn't really learned anything, because Luffy looks like he's about to try and fight. And what you get is how Pedro shows up, and Pedro basically says, Luffy, you can't touch this. And then Jinbe shows back up, and Jinbe's pushing things back a little further as well. And so it looks like it's going to be a two-on-one with Jinbe and Pedro versus Katakuri. But when this happens, when it seems like Luffy might actually be captured, Luffy stretches out his arms, and Luffy shows that picture to Big Mom. And it looks like Big Mom, when she sees it, she says, Mother. And again, you see the highly expressive look on her face. It's really great expressive art, where you see the upper left corner of her eye. You see the tears, the shock. And then all on the side panels, you just see everybody's reactions to everything. And I love how Reiju just has that peaceful look on her face, because she's still got the gun to her head. She's waiting for it to come. But we see something that I don't recall seeing since really Whitebeard, where Whitebeard lets off that ability with his devil fruit, and it cracks the area around him. Now, Big Mom, she lets out this scream, and I can't tell if it's just, you know, power radiating off of her, or if she's actually cracking some of the atmosphere in her surrounding. I'd be very interested to see this animated. But, you know, what I like is how everyone's like, okay, here's that moment. Here we go. And, like, all of Cake Island looks like, or at least the top of that wedding cake looks like it's kind of caving in a little bit. And I don't know whether or not that's Supreme King hockey or not. I know I tend to overrate a lot of that stuff, but it's going to be very interesting to see how Oda kind of wraps that up. But, you know, my chapter question for you guys is going to be, how did you feel about the ending, where you have this moment where basically Capone is ready to try and strike down Big Mom, because Big Mom's vulnerable. And I wonder if her being vulnerable goes down to, I guess, this flashback with her own mother. Did something happen with her own mother? I'm going to be very interested to see how this is explained. As always, guys, if you like anything I had to say, don't forget to comment, rate, subscribe, and share. Thank you so much for watching until the end. Have an awesome day, guys.